Greetings. How many times have you considered John the Baptist? Really examined what was written about him? Jesus spoke about John several times, and each carries important information to understand. Luke 7:18. Then John's disciples informed him about all these things. So John called two of his disciples and sent them to ask the Lord, meaning Jesus, "Are you the one who was to come, or should we look for someone else?" The men came to Jesus and said, "John the Baptist sent us to ask, 'Are you the one who was to come, or should we look for someone else?'" Clearly, John was looking for someone, looking for somebody. At that very hour, Jesus healed many people of their diseases, afflictions, and evil spirits, and he gave sight to many who were blind. Healed many, gave sight to many who were blind. So he replied, follow the sequence here. Jesus is asked, are you the one John is looking for? That very hour, Jesus heals many. Jesus gives sight to many blind people. Jesus is laying the groundwork for his answer. Now he replies. So he replied, go back and report to John what you have seen and heard. The blind receive sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the good news is preached to the poor. Jesus does not need to say, I am God. Jesus does not need to say, I am the prophet. Jesus does not need to say, I am the Lord spoken of by prophet Malachi. Jesus only needs to meet the details that John will know, foretold by the prophets of Yahweh. Luke 4:14, and Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news about him spread through all the surrounding district. This is a little earlier in Jesus' ministry. And he began teaching in their synagogues, and was praised by all. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and as was his custom, he entered the synagogue on the Sabbath and stood up to read. And the book of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him. And he opened the book and found the place where it was written, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set free those who are oppressed, to proclaim the favorable year of the Lord. And he closed the book, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. That's Isaiah 61:1. The Spirit of the Lord God is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release from darkness to the prisoners, to proclaim the favorable year of the Lord. And he stopped there. The next phrase is, and the day of vengeance of our God. John knows who Isaiah was talking about. John knew what details to look for. Jesus knew what Isaiah had foretold. Those were the details of his credentials. Jesus did not need to say, I am God. So John's messengers went back to John, and John had his answer. Keep the following in mind. Prophet John the Baptist was looking for someone, and John knew why he was looking for that someone. John was looking for the second messenger of Malachi 3:1. Luke 7:24. After John's messengers had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed swaying in the wind? If not, what did you go out to see? A man dressed in fine clothes? Look, those who wear elegant clothing and live in luxury are found in palaces. But what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, "Behold, I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you." Whenever a phrase like, "about whom it is written," is used in the New Testament, look it up. You will find it in the Old Testament. So Jesus said, "It is written," and we can find it in the book of Isaiah. God has preserved His Word. The New Testament agrees with and fulfills the Old Testament. Contrast this with Muhammad's Quran. Whenever Muhammad claimed something was to be found in the Torah and Bible, absolutely nothing can be found. Surah 7, 157 claims you can find a description of a prophet who cannot read nor write. No such description can be found. Surah 61:6 claims Jesus said some words foretelling of a future man named Ahmad. No such words can be found. Whenever Jesus or Peter or Paul says, "It is written," or "as was written by the prophets," you can find that message, just as they said it existed. Whenever Muhammad claims something is written, absolutely nothing like it can be found. Do you believe the men you can prove spoke the truth, or do you believe the man who said nothing that could be confirmed? Eternity is a long time for a stupid decision. Let's get back to John the messenger foretold by Prophet Malachi. I honestly wanted to focus on John. In all my years of church services and Bible studies, I don't think I ever once heard Malachi 3:1 taught on. This is the one about whom it is written, "Behold, I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you." This is one of the instances a prophet of Yahweh God was foretold. Jesus has just identified John as the first messenger of Malachi 3:1. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me." Just let this percolate for a moment. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me." Prophet Malachi reveals Yahweh God's message. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me." Jesus recites the same message. "Behold, I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you." Similar, but not identical. Let's look at these phrases a little closer. Malachi 3:1, "Behold, I will send my messenger," and Jesus speaking, "Behold, I will send my messenger." So far, so good. An exact match. But next, we see three voices enter the text. There is God speaking to someone. There is what Malachi heard, and there is what Jesus heard. I don't mean what Jesus heard when someone read Malachi 3:1. I mean what Jesus heard when God originally said it to Jesus in heaven. Sometimes prophets were told to record what they were told to say. For example, Psalm 2:7, "I will declare the decree the Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee." and sometimes prophets were told to record what they saw in a vision. Daniel 7:13, I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him. How would it be recorded if Prophet Malachi were shown a conversation between Yahweh God the Father and Yahweh God the Son? God says something like, Yeshua, when you go down to earth, I will send my messenger before you to prepare your way for you. God the Father would use the second person singular pronoun you speaking to God the Son. And what might Jesus, God the Son, actually hear? I will send my messenger before you to prepare your way for you. Think back to the exact way Jesus recites this passage. I will send my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way before you. All second person, singular, personal pronouns, as if it were spoken directly to Jesus. I have to honestly question whether Jesus is reciting Malachi or relaying his recollection of his conversation with God as Jesus heard it. And Malachi simply recorded, filtered by his understanding, what he thought he heard. Get this firmly locked in your mind. This is God speaking. God says, my messenger. Malachi 3:1, my messenger. Behold, I will send my messenger. Jesus repeats this portion with perfect accuracy. It is the second half of the text that is different. Behold, I will send my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way before you. Jesus repeats this as if God were speaking to someone else and not Malachi, using the second person personal pronoun you. Malachi was a Jew. Malachi was a monotheistic Jew. Malachi was a monotheistic Jew and a prophet. It is as if Malachi hears God's statement, God's conversation to another being. And Malachi has recorded as faithfully as he could what he understood Yahweh, God the Father, to say to another being in the heavenly realm who had attributes that qualified this second being as Yahweh God. Then the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple. Yahweh God the Father said this other being would come to his temple. When God says his, God is speaking of this other being and his temple, the other being's temple. Otherwise, God would speak and say, this other entity will come to my temple. So this means the temple belonged to this other being. But clearly, Jesus identified Prophet John by the words of Prophet Malachi. And I personally think that is one of the most significant fulfillments of all Old Testament prophecy. If John is the first messenger of Malachi 3:1, Jesus is Yahweh God come to his temple. Establishing John as the first messenger of Malachi 3:1 is therefore of paramount importance. And we'll get to more on that in part 2 of this series. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.